Hello, Scorpio. Hello and welcome to your September 2023 General Celtic Cross. Let's see what Spirit would like to draw your attention to for September. Your central energy for this spread here today. Fantastic. Is the fool. What adventures are you going on in September? It looks like you're starting something new. Looks like you're embracing whatever without necessarily knowing where it's going or having the guarantees or the answers. But, you know, you're doing it. You're doing something. You're doing something fun, something awesome. I don't think you fully know what to expect, but it's kind of... And I hate this phrase, but I'm going to use it. It's a bit YOLO, right? Crossing you is the death card. Wow, this is beautiful, Scorpio. What gorgeous energy. Yeah, you firmly put something behind you in the past, and you're leaping into your future. Lies at the root of the situation is the Knight of Pentacles. Ah, okay. There may have been something here that you've waited for. You've waited, waited, and waited. And I think you've hit a point when you thought, do you know what? It's not coming. It's not happening. I'm tired of waiting. I am tired of putting my life on pause, putting my life on hold. I'm moving on now. I'm going to embrace something new. Maybe you waited for someone romantically and it's not manifested, so you're moving on with somebody new. Maybe you waited for the promotion or the pay rise and that hasn't manifested, so you're off to go and get a new job somewhere where you feel maybe I'll be appreciated there. Who knows? Like I said, you don't know where you're going, but you know what you're leaving for sure. Recent past is the Hanged Man. There's you stuck in the past. This is definitely you wiggling yourself free from the mud in which you were stuck in and leaping forward into your future. Beautiful. On your mind is the Page of Wands. Look how excited you are. Excited for the possibilities. Open-minded, enthusiastic, working on the future that is in front of you. This is a very forward-thinking energy for you here, Scorpio. Coming in for you is the Strength card. Gorgeous. The Strength card, amongst many things, is a reminder that there are ways to get what you want other than brute force. I suppose the, you know, you win, you get more flies with honey than you do vinegar kind of parable would work there. Although I'm not sure why anybody would want flies, but but you get the idea. You know that. It's a question of bending rather than breaking. Your advice and guidance is the Ten of Pentacles. Beautiful. Mercury in Virgo. Oh, just quickly go through the signs. We've got Major Arcana for Leo. Your Major Arcana here, central for you, which is the Death card. We've also got Major Arcana for Pisces there. We've got Major Arcana for Aquarius. Goodness me. Major. I've just realized that. The only, if we take the court cards out of the equation, the Knight of Pentacles and the Page of Wands here, the only minor arcana that you have thus far is in your advice position with the Ten of Pentacles here, which is a Virgo. It's about being committed to the perfect home, the perfect family, an orderly environment. I do think, even though you don't have guarantees or you're not fully sure what to expect, I don't think that means that you have just abandoned any semblance of big picture long-term thinking. I feel you do still have a long-term goal, but you are taking a chance on something now and let's see where that goes. Somebody else in this equation is represented by the Queen of Pentacles, which is gorgeous. You have the Knight and the Ten of Pentacles. Yeah, you're getting some grounded energy coming up through here, manifesting this kind of flight of fancy and all of this internal excitement and hope into something real and tangible here. I think you've got somebody here that you can rely on, okay? I think you've got somebody here who is responsible, reliable and hardworking. You've got somebody here who is down to earth and practical. Your hopes and fears, there's the Five of Swords. Mercury, no, it's not Mercury, it's Venus. Venus in Aquarius. And you've got Aquarius here in your main central energy. Aquarius is the 11th house. It's about the future. Again, amongst many other things. It's also about surprises. Let's get your final card out. Your overall outcome here is the Four of Swords. Okay, pace yourself, I would suggest. Pace yourself. We start off very, very enthusiastic and very, very exciting, but then we kind of stutter and stall a little bit with the momentum as we go on. I think this is you moving into a slightly second-guessy kind of place. I think you're throwing yourself in here to something after a period of stagnancy, after a period of waiting, a period of nothing much really, and getting frustrated with that. You've recognized that you want to take action, that it's time to take action. You are taking action. You're taking a chance. You're taking a risk. You're very excited about that possibility. As you move forward, you're recognizing, hey, you know, there were more options available to me. Would you look at that? You know, that maybe at one point in the past, you felt as though your hands were tied. You felt as well, or your foot was tied more accurately. But this is kind of this revelationary energy of, hey, you know, there are other ways to achieve what I want to achieve. And focusing on yourself, getting yourself out there, courage, compassion, generosity, you know, it's like you're kind of, it's like you're being the change you want to see. I know that, again, that's a bit of a platitude, but that's kind of, you know, I think you've recognized here, you know, I want people in my life that are kind and compassionate and giving and generous and passionate and fun and exciting and interesting. Therefore, I am going to be all of those things. So I attract people on that same frequency. I mean, oh, you've nailed it. If that's the mindset that you're going into this, absolutely, absolutely nailed. But then what we have going up the staff here is a few more grounded concerns, kind of pulling you down just a touch. And I think what's going on here is you're kind of launching yourself with wild abandon into this new, exciting, passionate thing. I don't know, like, I'm trying to think of an example. I don't know, something ridiculous, something daft, but fun and actually so important vibrationally, like starting salsa classes, I don't know. Something like that, right? Or I would suggest something much, much bigger and more important, given all these major arcanas. But then it's like, you know, maybe in the example, the cooking and the cleaning needs doing, or a family member needs you to mind their children, something, you know, and we're kind of being pulled back to the things that you're responsible for, the people you're responsible for, the people that you support, in terms of the home and the family. I don't see any reason why you can't have both. I think the important thing to note, however, is to pace yourself, is to absolutely pace yourself and make sure that you're not spreading yourself too thin. You know, if like 50% of you is pursuing this new exciting venture with somebody, perhaps, maybe a new love, maybe a new job, maybe a new passion project, and then 50% of you here is dedicated to your home and your family and being there essentially for the people that rely on you, then, you know, you're left with precisely 0% there for yourself or a bit of downtime. So just be wary of the proportion in which you are dedicating. You can have both. You can absolutely have both. I think it's worth considering what is a priority and what is not a priority. You know, don't sweat the small stuff. You know, if the dishwasher goes unloaded for a day It really is not the end of the world. You have not let yourself down. You have not let everybody else down. Delegate. Ask somebody else to do that. You know, if you're focusing on something else, if you want to go out on a hot date with this new person that you're interested in, my goodness me, leave the vacuuming or the hoovering or the dusting or the cleaning for another day. Or if somebody wants you to mind their children and you're exhausted, you're tired, you need to rest, it's okay to say no. It is okay to say no sometimes. I think whatever it is you're pursuing here, this new beautiful thing that you're throwing yourself into with wild abandon, I think it's about time, given that I see the Knight of Pentacles and the Hanged Man kind of in this past residual energy over here. I think you've waited for this and it's about time. And I think with a little bit of delegation and a little bit of prioritizing, carefully weighing up, like balancing the juggling act of having this for you and continuing to be this supportive figure for the people that rely on you, I think you can have it all. I really do think that you can have it all. I'm going to move this over to the extended. The link to that is, as always, in the description. Let us get a final card for Scorpio from the Everyday Witch Oracle, just to ground your energy. Give us like a little prompt of something that you should be paying attention to here. And you have affirmation for positive change. Look at you shedding your old skin and heading towards something new. How exciting. Yeah, change is coming. Something new is literally right here for you. Shed your skin. You know, I feel like it is like a shedding of the skin, like some of the masks that you wore, or not masks, like uniforms that you wore, like metaphorically, like the uniform of being a caregiver to your family members, the uniform of being the house person, the uniform of being a particular job that you were doing, or the uniform of being a single person. You're casting that off, or maybe you're casting off the uniform of being a attached person and you're now in a single energy. Either way, you're shedding the old. And there is a new thing here, ready and willing and waiting for you to embrace it. I see you want to. I see you're ready to. The only thing I think you need to be wary of is just pacing yourself. Yes, I can see you want to throw yourself in with wild abandon here. The Fool card, the Page of Wands. You know, nothing is going to hold you back here. Just pace yourself and make sure that you're attending to everything that you need. I'll see some of you over in the extended. Take care.